What are the best budget loadouts in Escape from Tarkov from level 21 to level 39? That's the topic of today's video. Dear comrades, Ivan the German is back, glad to have you here, and today we are talking about the best loadouts from level 21 to level 39 in Escape from Tarkov. We have a lot of different opportunities, and of course you can combine the previous videos, and you should do that, of course. So what you should do right now, because this video is very important for you, grab a beer or two or any other drink, and let's start with the loadouts. I would say let's start with the weapons first. On top I have the 5.7. You can get the 5.7 from Peacekeeper level 3, and you can have Peacekeeper level 3 with level 18, which is quite early in my opinion, and you should use that. And the 5.7 is the best pistol in Escape from Tarkov right now. You should combine the 5.7 with some mediocre level 4 armored rigs, and this is your foundation for some very nice pistol runs. You can do my low risk customs or even some high risk runs on interchange. With the 5.7, you are good to go. Let's continue with the MP7, and the MP7 is together with the Vector the best SMG in the game in my opinion, especially the MP7A1. You don't need that much to have a pretty decent SMG. I would spend the extra money to get the Rotex suppressor, because look at the stats, 44 recoil and 50 ergo without a mag is very nice in my opinion. Try to get some FMJ ammunition, or if you don't have the trader level you can use subsonic ammunition, but I would try to get some FMJ. Let's continue with the P90, and the P90 has the same principles like the MP7. You don't need that much to have a very decent SMG. You can buy, and you should buy, the suppressor from the flea market. It's cheaper compared to the Mechanix trade. And just a small hint, the P90 is very nice against raiders or some mid-tier opponents, but if your opponent has better armor like level 5 or 6, your time to kill, even with the best ammunition, is quite high. Your recoil is low, you have 50 round max, and your fire rate is quite high. The P90 is perfect to kill raiders or make some money in loot runs. It's a perfect PDV, but if you are focusing on PvP, I would grab the MP7. Let's make it clear, the VSS is still a very decent gun in Escape from Tarkov, because with the right ammunition, your time to kill is quite low. On top of that, with the VSS, you have a very budget firearm if you are doing it right. As you can see right here, I've mounted a pretty simple magpul grip, and from prepper level 3, you have a barter with 4 pliers to get 1 30 round mag. So what you should do, and that's what I recommend all the time, you can use 1 very good mag with some decent ammo in your gun, and you can put 1 like 30 round mag in your secure container. Let's continue with the RPK. In my opinion, the RPK is the best 5.45x39 weapon build right now in Escape from Tarkov, and on top of that, it is quite budget. It's not so expensive to run a pretty decent RPK build. It doesn't matter if you play the short barrel or the long barrel version, in my opinion both are pretty neat, and you can get the shift grip from Peacekeeper level 3. Of course you can change the grip to the Magpul grip. In my opinion, the Magpul RVG is pretty nice. From prepper level 3, you can buy the KS23 for 45k. This thing is quite annoying, but it's also very efficient. Why not using it? If you have Mechanic level 3, you can make a lot of very budget HK416 and M4A1 builds, very budget builds. I made 2 videos about the HK and 1 video about a budget M4. You should check them out if you're interested. So if you are able to buy the parts needed for these weapon builds, for the HK416 and for the M4A1, it's the perfect moment to start playing some 5.56x45. A little bit underrated and very rare is 3.66 out of the Vapor AKM in Escape from Tarkov right now, in my opinion. The big question is, do you have to play a fully modded Vapor AKM, because the recoil is still quite high, you have to suppress it, so these parts are still a little bit expensive, but the ammunition is great. So what you can do is like play some budget Vapor AKM builds and drop your weapon after you killed the first enemy. And in the end, I want to show you a modded SVD. Why? Because especially on paper, with some SNB ammunition, and it's important that you are not using 7N1, because 7N1 is not good. Play the SVD or the Mosin with SNB ammunition. The reason for that is quite simple. So even if you play 7N1 with a SVD or Mosin, most of the times you are not one-shotting your opponent. And that's the reason why you have to play, especially the SVD, with some SMB ammunition. SMB is horrible cheap, and you can penetrate almost everything, and you can double tap almost every enemy. Let's continue with the gear. From Prepper level 3, you can buy the Korund. There is a barter and you need 4 diaries. It's still worth to get the Korund for this barter because you will get it back from the insurance quite often. You can buy the Giselle from Ragman level 3, which is also very decent, but you have to consider that if you have to repair it, you will lose a lot of durability. Then we have the level 4 TV rig, which is great if you are doing some loot runs, because as you can see right now, you have a lot of space in your TV rig. You have the barter with some bleach and shampoo. That's why you should consider keep bleach or craft shampoo and all of that stuff in your hideout. And this barter from Ragman is not that bad. Then we have the M1 barter from Ragman level 3. In my opinion, it's still worth to do this barter because Kvass is very common. It's cheap, you can get it, and you need 4 aquamarine. Aquamarine is still not so expensive. You can find them also very often, or if you want to buy the M1 rig on the market, it's still pretty cheap to get. Then you should consider the barter to get the Tech from Ragman level 3. It's one of the best rigs in my opinion in Escape from Tarkov right now. It's a level 5 armored rig. You have some decent amount of space and I just like the Tech. Then we have a barter from Ragman level 3 for condensed milk to get the MPPV rig, which is quite nice in my opinion, but you can also buy it from the Flea. And still one of my biggest recommendations, use some tactical headsets because you need every information you can get. And like Zordines or Comtex are bugged sometimes. And if you like face shields, the Kiver M is pretty cheap right now. And early wipe, this combination is very good. You can get a lot of them from Rashala's Guards, which is the Scav boss on Customs. And the next upgrade is the LZSH in combination with the multi-hit ballistic face shield. Don't buy the LZSH from Ragman, buy it on the Flea. And in the end, your medical supplies, you can buy salivas, hemo, splints. And of course, you should use some quick painkillers like morphine, or if you can afford it, Probital. Probital is insane. Try to use Probital if you can afford it. So what do you think about all these opportunities from level 21 to 39? Write a comment in the comment section below. And as always, your support is insane and we Germans want to win at least something. And if it's your like, don't forget to like this video. It really helps, and see you in the next video, guys.